out for nasty weather out there. Amen. Thank you for being faithful to the house of God and looking for a great time in the Lord tonight. Let's give Jesus a great big hand clap tonight. Amen. Thank you for being with us tonight.
I took off the weight. I've laid down the sin. I've made up my mind that I'm going to win. The shackles have fallen. The chains now are gone. I'm running with Jesus and I'm going.
Tonight. Amen. Let's welcome the Lord in our midst tonight. Lord, we just thank you, Lord, for being here in our midst tonight. Lord, we just praise you for what you're going to do in this service tonight. Lord, we ask you to pour out upon us, Lord God. We thank you for it, Lord. We thank you for keeping us, Lord, blessing our homes, Lord, blessing our kids, Lord. We thank you for doing a work in this house tonight, Jesus. We thank you tonight. Again, thank you guys for being with us. Thank you for putting forth the effort. Sister Doris, I'd ask you to come and sing or If you can't sing or something, maybe testify. We appreciate everyone being with us tonight. Amen. Looking for a great time in the Lord tonight. And Lord sees your sacrifice. Amen. And no matter how you feel in the Lord, I love in the Bible where it says, those that are last shall be made first. Amen. Those that are shall be the least of all people shall be made the greatest. Amen. Ask Joseph, amen, when he was down in the dungeon, he was nothing but a prisoner, and how God brought him out. I don't care how low you are tonight or how bad you feel, God is a promoter. Amen. God is a promoter, amen, to those that are felt to left out and those are left behind. God is looking to push them to the front. Amen. So I tell you tonight, I hope you're here to be blessed tonight. Jesus loves you. Again, thank you for being with us.
Well, I woke up this morning, there was no hurt at my door.
Much to be thankful for tonight, amen. And we're going to get ready to receive tonight's offering, amen. The offering takers have come, we'll get ready to receive that, amen. And while they're coming tonight, give Robin a big hand as she sings tonight, amen. Yeah. Brother Charlie Dial, stand and say something for the Lord tonight. Amen. Good to have my buddy Michael. Brother, you want to stand and say something for the Lord tonight? Come on.
Yeah, you, buddy.
Yeah.
Good to have you tonight. Amen.
Yeah.
Amen.
Thank you, Lord.
be my provider. Lord, you take care of me. Lord, you're my God, my strength in the time of need. Oh, you're there to take, Lord, to take care of your bride. And what would I do, Lord, if I didn't have you? After all these years, you've been there for me. You've been there in the good times. You've been there in the bad times. Oh, Lord, what would I do without you? You've been there, Lord, all these years. You've been my provider. Lord, you've taken care of me. You're my God. Lord, you're my strength in the time of need. You're there to take, just to take care of your
Bible said he gives unto us watchmen. Hallelujah. Amen. He sits upon a wall, and they shall not hold their peace day or night. Amen. Help me make welcome tonight our pastor, Thank Brother Keith, tonight.
Thank you, Lord.
Well, let's give the Lord one more big shout of praise tonight. Hallelujah. Come on, let's give the Lord a great big shout of praise. Amen. Turn around and tell somebody, say, good to see you in the house of the Lord tonight. Amen. Hallelujah. Give me the key of G, Jeannie. Hallelujah. Amen. Let's give the Lord one more shout of praise tonight, would you? Come on, let's give the Lord one more shout of praise. Hallelujah. How many knows He's a good God tonight? Amen. Thank you for being with us tonight. God bless you. Amen. Appreciate your love and your sacrifice tonight. Amen. Let's just sing a chorus of this song. We'll see the bright light shine. It's just about home time. I can see my Father standing. He's at the door. This whole world has been a wilderness. I'm ready for deliverance. And Lord, I said, we're building home. Send me home. Everybody sing. We'll see the bright light shine. It's just about home time. And I can see the Father standing. He's at the door. Well, this whole world has been a wilderness. I'm ready for deliverance. And Lord, I've never been this whole. Spread my wings for flying. Lord, I've never been this home. Sing before, sing with me tonight, church. We'll see the bright light shine. It's just about home. See the bright light shine. It's just about home time. And I can see my Father standing. He's at the door. This whole world has been a wilderness. I'm ready for deliverance. And Lord, I've never been this home. Sing me home. Lord, I've never been this home. Take me home. Hallelujah. Would you give the Lord, amen, another praise tonight? Amen. Hallelujah. He's a mighty good God tonight. Amen. Before we read the Word of God, just sing this chorus with me tonight. Singing, amen, Amazing Grace tonight. Amen. How many knows it? How many's glad for Amazing Grace tonight? Amen. Sing it with us, just a chorus of it. Amazing Grace, how sweet the sound. Come on, lift your voices and sing it. A wretch like me. Hallelujah.
Was blind, but now I see.
Sing it, church.
When we
give the
the Lord. One more shout of praise if you believe that tonight. Amen. Hallelujah. Come on, let's give the Lord a shout of praise tonight. Amen. Hallelujah. How many knows it's good to be in the house of the Lord? It's a privilege to be in the house of the Lord tonight. Amen. Amen. Again, thank you for coming tonight. Open your Bibles tonight. Amen. And Psalms 136 tonight. Psalms 1, chapter 136. Amen. Amen. Psalms 136 tonight. Now, amen, I want you to know tonight that God's a good God. How many knows that God's a good God? And I want you to tell your neighbor tonight, it may be a little cold outside, maybe a little snowy outside, but I'll tell you what we can do. We can slew a big man, a giant. Amen. We can kill a lion. Amen. And we can win the victory. How many believes that tonight? That's the word of God. Hallelujah. Amen. Amen. Psalms 136 tonight. And, you know, sometimes, you know, you ever look at somebody and say, well, they don't need prayer. You ever look at somebody and say, well, they don't need prayer. Everybody needs prayer. You know, when you look at somebody and say, well, you know, I don't see nothing wrong. They don't have anything to even do with it. We never know what's going on in somebody's heart, their mind, their battle. We don't know what, you know, of how the devil is even fighting their minds to torment them that, you know, they may die, they may, you know, something going to happen or amen or ever what. But how many knows the devil is a liar tonight? And I want you to raise your hand with me tonight and say this with me. God remembers me. Say that again. Now, sometimes I can remember you. Sometimes you can remember me. But God never forgets who you are and where you at and what your need is. How many believes that tonight? Amen. So Psalms 136, amen, verse 23 tonight. Then we're going into 137, Daniel. Amen. The Bible says, who remembers us in our lowest state or in our afflictions or in our weaknesses. That's what that means right there. The God who remembers us in our lowest state or in our afflictions and in our weakness. For his mercy endures forever. How many knows that God's mercy endures forever this morning or night? Amen. Excuse me. And has redeemed us from the enemies for his mercy. And we're going back to the mercies of God endureth forever. How many glad for the mercies of God tonight? Amen. Now look at this. Who giveth food to all flesh for his mercies. And I believe the psalmist is trying to get us to understand something here. Amen. The mercies of God, amen, are beyond anything that you can imagine tonight. Now raise your hand and shout, I'm in the mercies of God tonight. If it wasn't for the mercies of God, none of us would be here. Amen. Hallelujah. How many knows that God's a good God? Amen. Next verse, please. Amen. Oh, give thanks unto the God of heaven for his. Now, I don't know about y'all, but that makes me want to shout because I need the mercies of God. How many of y'all need the mercies of God tonight? And he goes there, he said, now God remembers us. Back in verse 23, God remembers us. Now, but they got the feeling, like the children of Israel got the feeling that God had forgotten them. How many knows that God can't forget you? We'll find that out in a few minutes. By the rivers of Babylon, there we sat down, yea, and we wept, amen, when they remembered Zion. They remembered what it used to be, and it wasn't that way no more, and they wept, amen. And they not only wept, but they began to hang their harps up on the willows in the midst thereof, amen. For they that carried us away captive required of us a song that they may waste us, required of us mirth, saying, sing us one of the songs of Zion. Somebody shout hallelujah. Hallelujah. And then they asked, they said this, how shall we sing the Lord's song in a strange land? Amen. There's a time when we get into a situation, we don't feel like singing the songs of God. Amen. Because we feel like we're just lost. We're wandering. But listen to what the psalmist said. If I forget thee, O Jerusalem, let my right hand forget her cunning or her ability to play. Amen. If I do not remember thee, let my tongue cleave to the roof of my mouth. If I prefer not Jerusalem above my chief joy. Amen. Brother Jim, say the prayer of the reading of the word. Amen. One more time, as you're seated, would you give the Lord a praise tonight? Amen. Now, there's a commercial on TV that talks about Carvana. How many's ever heard that name, Carvana? Amen. But there's a Hebrew word called Kavana. And this Hebrew word means, I want you to listen to this for a moment. This Kavana in the Hebrew means this, to be aware of God's presence. Now, I don't know if you understand that, but when you are aware of the presence of God, it changes everything about your situation. It makes you aware that there's something greater, amen, than what you're facing. Amen. This word, Kavana, it means this, amen. It means to be aware of the presence of God. And then I wrote down this right here. That's why I preach, because I'm aware of the presence of God. That's why I go other places and have revivals and preach, amen, to the lost, amen. And amen, doing my best to encourage pastors and amen, to bring the awareness of God's presence and His transforming glory to our lives. Now, when we start remembering what God's done, it starts changing and transforming our outlook of what God wants to do. How many believes that tonight? Amen. Hallelujah. Now, amen, here's my perspective, amen, on this tonight. When the presence of God gets into something, everything changes. I know you already know that, but I want to bring to your remembrance tonight. How many of y'all ever, amen, get to battling so much that you really forget about the goodness of God? Say amen. Amen. Now, this word remember, I wish you could write this down tonight as God began to deal with on this. The word remember, it's a deeper meaning than just to bring to one's mind. Now, that is one type of remembrance, to be able to bring to one's mind. And that's part of this. But also to act on that person's behalf. Now watch this. When you remember something, how many's ever remembered something and you went and done something for somebody? On that person's behalf. Now when God remembers us, in our afflictions and in our weaknesses and in our sicknesses and in our trials, God says, I'm going to intervene on your behalf. How many glad that God wants to intervene on your behalf tonight? How many wants God to intervene in your troubles tonight, in your depression, against every power and force of hell? Amen. The devil may try to monkey with your nerves, but I want you to know, I believe that God is going to intervene on the behalf to have that awareness and a realization that He's not just a God of the past, but He's God of the now and of the future. Somebody give God a shout of praise in here. Amen. Amen. The 16th chapter of the book of Judges, you'll find that Samson there. Then you'll find that he got, amen, finally got his eyes gouged out. And, amen, he was in trouble. And, amen, he couldn't see. And they had him down there in that grist mill. And they was grinding the corn, amen, for the Philistines. Amen. But they brought him to the temple to make sport of him. And, amen, to make mockery of him and his God. But you know what Samson said? God, would you remember me? God, would you do something on my behalf? I don't know about who somebody in here tonight, but God's going to intervene on somebody's behalf and show Himself strong by the power of God. Anybody need God to intervene tonight? Anybody need God to touch tonight? Anybody need God to walk into your situation tonight? Now, when you get God to get intervening, things change. Somebody shout hallelujah. Now watch this. The word remember not only brings to, amen, to be come to one's mind, but also to act on a person's behalf, to have the awareness and the realization. This is what God told me to, amen, to really get into our hearts and our lives. Go to Genesis chapter 8, Daniel. Genesis chapter number 8 tonight. Now, when you look at this scripture and you understand something, amen, everything was wrong. People's hearts, it got wicked. Men, amen, their hearts was continually, their minds and their imagination was continually evil as it is today. And you don't hear a lot of good. But the Bible says, and God remembered Noah. And God said on the Bible, behalf of Noah. I'm going to do something for him that nobody else is going to get it. You know what I'm saying? Folks, that's important when you're in trouble. You may be here tonight and got no problems, but tomorrow you may wake up with a pile of troubles. Amen. And God remembered what? Noah. God remembered Noah. And when God remembered Noah, he said, Noah, I'm going to give you my grace. Somebody give God just a shout of praise there. Come on, let's stand and give God a shout of praise on that tonight. Hallelujah. I said hallelujah tonight. Oh, yes. Amen. Listen to chapter 6, Daniel. Go there. Amen. In verse number 8 of chapter 6, listen to what God done for Noah. But Noah found grace in the eyes of the Lord and the generations of Noah. Noah was a just man and a perfect in his generation. And Noah walked with God. Amen. Noah remembered God and tried his best to please him and walk in his ways. And then when trouble came, guess who remembered Noah? Amen. It pays, amen, to walk in the goodness of God tonight. Somewhere you're going to need help that man can't give you. And nobody else can help you with, but only God. And when God intervenes, things are going to happen. Amen. Amen. How many, somebody asked you to, for something, or maybe said, can I borrow something ever what? And you said, yeah. And they said, do this with it, do that with it. And you forgot. You got down the road. And you remembered it. And I've known people, and I have myself, turn around and go back and do what I remembered or told them I would do. Now, God don't have to do that. But God says, I know you enough that I'm going to remember you. Got to remember you. Listen to me tonight. In the 38th chapter of the book of Isaiah, there was a man, and his name was Hezekiah. He was a king of Judah in Israel there. Amen. And the prophet Isaiah, God told Isaiah, you go into to Hezekiah and tell him, amen, that he's going to die and not live and set his house in order. Amen. And Isaiah walked out of the court. Amen. And brother, he turned his face to the wall. And in God, he told God, he said, God, you remember me when I walked upright. God, how I done this. I opened the house of God. I caused a revival to happen in the house of God. I brought revival back to Israel. I know I may have missed the mark, but God, remember me. And the Bible said, God remembered Hezekiah and told Isaiah to go back and tell him, I'm going to give him 15 years. I feel that tonight as God gave me this message, God's about to intervene in somebody. He's going to remember something that you have done and get rewarded for it by the power of God. You may have forgotten it, but God has not forgotten it tonight. So, man, the Bible in the book of Esther, his name is Mordecai. Mordecai, amen, saved the king's life. Amen, from two of his guards was going to kill the king, Ahasuerus. Amen, was going to kill him. And amen, and Mordecai, amen, heard the plot, and he told the king that he was going to, amen, this is going to happen. They executed those two guys, and it was wrote in the book of remembrance. My God, somebody, amen, what Mordecai done. But one night the king couldn't sleep because there was a wicked man down the road, amen, building gallows, amen, to hang Mordecai and get rid of all the Jews. But the king couldn't sleep. The king got restless. They brought the book of remembrance, and all of a sudden they begin to write, read, and all of a sudden here came the words, and Mordecai saved the life of the king. And the king said, what has he been rewarded for? They said he hasn't had no reward. Haman hated Mordecai because Mordecai was righteous. He wouldn't bow, give homage to him as a god. And Mordecai devised, or Haman disguised a plan, amen, to kill Mordecai and all the Jewish people. But I want you to understand something. Amen. Haman, that hated him, that was building the gallows. Amen. Amen. The king read this. Amen. What has been done to the man that saved my life? His name was Mordecai. They said nothing. And all of a sudden, amen, Haman did not know what was going on. And he happened to come into the palace that day early to get permission to kill Mordecai. Y'all want to hear the story? And the king said, Haman, I want to ask you a question. What would you do to the man that the king delighteth in? And Haman is thinking to himself, there ain't nobody closer to the king than me. He said, I tell you what I would do. I'd get the king's horse. I'd put a robe on him of the king. I'd put a crown on his head. I'd get somebody to take him, the horse, amen, by the bridle. And I'd parade him down through town and say, this is the man whom the king delighteth in. Old Haman was feeling pretty good that he was getting ready to be coronated. Amen. But all of a sudden, the king stunned him. He said, you do that. You take that and get the horse and get it all ready and put the man Mordecai on the horse and tell him that the king delights in him. Oh, God, you may have forgotten it, but God ain't forgotten what you're going to get blessed with tonight. God, he forgot this. When God began to give me this, I said, God, I don't. God said, tell my people that I have not forgotten them. Hallelujah. And God's going to remember at the perfect time. See, God saves some things for the perfect time. Hello? Amen. Hallelujah. God saves some things for you to be rewarded at a specific time. All of your faithfulness has not gone unrewarded. All your prayers, God still hears them. Can I get a witness in here? See, God, he forgot you. Amen. Sometimes I forget a lot of things. And somebody will walk up and say, Brother Keith, you remember? I say, no, I don't remember that. Amen. They keep a talking. Amen. And finally, amen, I go back in the files and I find it. Somebody shout hallelujah. Amen. And I'm thinking, God, how good you've been to us. How good you've been to us. How good you've been to us. Brother Barney, I remember the time we was at Campbellsville, and y'all couldn't get on the tent. Y'all had to go over, the storm got so bad. Y'all went over to the station. Or y'all sat in the van, I can't remember. Amen. But try to get on the tent, we wouldn't let him. Water was coming out of there like a river under there. We could look out that little peephole, and them clouds were swirling. They were green, and I don't know what all colors they was. And I believe there was different times that devil tried to blow that tent down, and the hand of God just said, not tonight, devil. Just not tonight. You're not going to do this. The rain may come, but the house won't fall. Amen. The floods may come, but the house won't fall. The winds may blow, but the house ain't going to fall. My God, somebody ought to give your God a shout of praise tonight, because I want you to know something. God's not forgot. God's doing something on somebody's behalf. He's stepping in. Amen. And you're going to realize that he's still God tonight. Give him another shout of praise in here. Now, I'm going to tell you something. It's good. Go to Ecclesiastes 12 and 1. Amen. Let me tell you something. It's good while we're still young to remember God. Man. Now, let me tell you something. I don't know how old you are, but you're never going to be no younger than you are right now. So you're a young man compared to where you're going, or a young lady. Somebody say amen to that. Don't that make you feel better? Thank you. Somebody shout hallelujah. Amen. I'm as young as I'll ever be. Amen. Guy called me today. He said, I never met him before. Amen. He said, young man, I called him back and I said, that's worth $25, sir. I said, you don't. Somebody shout hallelujah again. Now remember this. Everybody shout remember. It's not only to call up the past, but it's also to act on the behalf of another person. To be aware that God is intervening not only in your past, has in your past, but in your future. The Bible says remember now. Is that word remember again? When you remember God in the days of your youth, your old age will be a whole lot better. And God can fight for your battles like he never fought for other people's battles. Amen. Amen. That's the truth. Living right pays off. Can I get a witness in here? Go to Malachi chapter 3 and verse 16. Amen. God's good. Somebody shout, God's good tonight. Amen. And let me tell you something. Amen. Old Haman, he thought he was still going to whoop and destroy Mordecai. But I want you to understand something. If God's hand's on you, all the devils of hell cannot destroy you. That ought to make you want to shout. Now, it may look like you're going down, but you ain't going down. Amen. Hallelujah. It's good to have y'all on that front seat tonight. Hallelujah. They're a noisy bunch. I like that. Holler at amen. Hallelujah. God's good. Hallelujah. I said God's good tonight. Amen. I said God's a mighty good God tonight. Folks, can you see this tonight? Amen. That God is intervening on your behalf right now. Right now. Right now. Sometimes it don't seem like we get in the fair end of things. Sometimes say, God, I've done all this, and God, this just don't seem fair. But it ain't over yet. It ain't over yet. It ain't over yet. Say, God will just open the door and make a way when there ain't no way. He'll do for you what nobody else can do for you. And the Bible says, they that feared the Lord spake often one to another. Those that loved the Lord and feared the Lord and they honored the Lord and they reverenced the Lord. That's what they was talking about it. How we get to talk about the goodness of God and how it was the Lord and all this. And amen. And the Lord hearkened, or he listened. He just didn't say, well, they're talking about me. No, he stopped. And he heard it. And a book of remembrance was written before him for them that feared the Lord and that thought upon his name. Do you realize every time you think upon the name of the Lord, it's put in a book? Every tear you shed is put in a bottle? Well, ain't no big deal. God knows every hair on your head. Somebody shout amen. Now look at this. Go to the next verse, Daniel. My God, I love this. I thought it was so good when God gave it to me. And they shall be mine, saith the Lord of hosts. In that day when I make up my jewels, I will spare them as a man spareth his own son that serves him. God said, I'll spare you. I'll keep you. I'll deliver you. I'll make a way for you. God's that good tonight. Listen, folks, we can go to God and say, God, amen. God, there's nothing I deserve. It's your mercies tonight. But God, I need a healing. And you paid that price. And God, remember when I prayed for others and I fasted for others and I stood in the gap. And amen. Let me tell you something, friend. Amen. Come here, son. Amen. I got a preacher friend. He's in heaven tonight. But he had four wayward children. And I mean, they was away from God. And he told God, when he said, God, I went over this whole country trying to preach for you and everything I could. Amen. I seen you save other people's children, their sons and their daughters. And he said, God, mine is so far away. Would you get a hold of them? And you know what happened? You know what happened? Amen. One night his daughter walked in. Amen. One day his son walked in. Amen. Someone went to somewhere else. But God began to save them. And he said, God, thank you. God, you remembered me. Well, God, I'm going to tell you, it's important when God remembers you. Do something for him that he'll remember you for. Thank you, son. And God saved them. And then big old tears run down his cheeks as he told me that. Amen. He said, look what the Lord has done for me. If your children are saved, look what the Lord's done for you. Amen. Look, your children sitting in the house of God tonight. That's something, amen, you can't buy that. Hallelujah. And I know, listen, I'm not giving, not telling you not to correct your children, but I'm going to tell you something. You got children in church tonight. Oh, God, you don't know how fortunate we are. Amen. When I see some of the trouble that some of these children give their parents, that they literally weary them to death. They put them under loads and stress that's beyond, it's unimaginable. Tell God, God, remember, I raised them in the house of God. God, I've done my best for you. Now get a hold of them. God, if they got to lay on a bed of fire, it'll be all right till they get it right. Amen. I'd rather lay on a bed of fire here under conviction than to lay on a hell of a bed of fire in the midst of hell tonight. Amen. God says, I'm gonna remember you. Can you remember? Can you imagine God remembering you? Can you remember God saying, oh, I remember Sister Audra. He'll call you daughter. He'll say, I remember my daughter. I remember my daughter. I remember my son. Wow. I remember all them times that you took that old truck that had no sleeper in it because you didn't want to stay on the road and you slept across the stern wheel. You know, God still got all them in the book. That I can't act like it want to. Because there's a book. That foot's got to be healed. There's a book. Now that devil come to steal, Brother Barney, but that God's got a book. He's got a book. God's got a book. God got a book of $1,000 you give me. That's right. I don't know how many times he's already blessed you, but he'll bless you again. Somebody shout hallelujah. Amen. That's good preaching, folks. God remembers tonight. And let me tell you, Haman built them gallows especially for Mordecai. But God was still working a plan because God remembered his people. God remembers you tonight. I don't know how God does it, but just be aware when you see God's hand, say, that's got to be God doing this. God be God doing this. God be God doing this. Because nobody else can't do this. If somebody calls you and says this, but you got to say, it's God that touched them for that. Oh, my God. Somebody shout hallelujah. I'm just telling you what God gave me a message. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Heaven knows he's good. Go with me to Isaiah 49, verses 14 through 16. Amen. Almost done here tonight. Amen. But I want to tell you something. There was two thieves hanging on a cross on each side of Jesus. And one of them thieves said this, Lord, remember me. I'm deserving what I'm getting. But you didn't do anything wrong. And I know that you're a just man. And you remember me when you come into your kingdom. And Jesus said something. Oh, my God. One got it, one missed it. And the one that said, would you remember me? The Lord said, I'll remember you. And today you'll be with me in paradise. I'm going to tell you, folks, that's something to shout about. You can come that close of missing it, and you can come that close of getting it. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. But Zion, this was the church. This was the tabernacle. This was where all the praise and the worship went on. And Zion said, the Lord has forsaken me, and my Lord has forgotten me. Think about that. Do you ever feel like God just about forgot you? I mean, in them dark times, you feel like God forgot. God, you know, you bless everybody else, and I struggle. Amen. And sometimes God lets us struggle for a purpose because others struggle. And you wouldn't know how to help them if you didn't know how to struggle. It's not mean that you're a failure, that you're weak, that you can't do it. Amen. But God says in your struggle, you'll have mercy too. If you can't have mercy, amen, you go through it and you can't have mercy on somebody else, you didn't learn nothing in it. Let me go over and preach a while to this side. Somebody shout hallelujah. Boy, I tell you what, amen, I've learned through some of my, amen, I got some scars. I got some things to tell you. I've learned some things. Amen. Back up, Daniel. Back it up, buddy. I want to just get this again. Amen. But Zion said, I got a whole load tonight. Amen. I got a whole load to Brother Barney. I'm going to feed all of y'all good. Take some home. But Zion said, the Lord has forsaken me, and my Lord has forgotten me. Wow. Can a woman forget her suckling child that she should not have compassion on the son of her womb? He's asking questions here. Yea, they might forget, yet I will not forget thee. Behold, I've engraven thee upon the palms of my hands, and thy walls are continually before me. How many knows you're engraven in the palms of his hand? God can't forget you. A mother should not forget her child, her baby that she delivered, that's part of her. But if she does, God says, I won't forget you. I can't forget you. You've been engraven and carved in the palms of my hands, he said. God, have mercy. When you're feeling lonely, just tell God, say, God, you said you'd never leave me and you'll never forsake me. God, you said you'd go all the way with me even until the end. Amen. Raise your hand and say, God, I thank you for your mercies tonight. Tell your neighbors, God's been so good to me. Say it again, God's been so good to me. Say it again, say, God's been so good to me. Oh, go with me one more place tonight, or couple. Go to Nehemiah 4:14. Remember the presence of God tonight. How many's ever seen God just intervene and you know it was the hand of God? You know what God was saying? I'm remembering you. Amen. I don't care how bad you've fallen. God remembers you tonight. Amen. I looked and I rose up and said unto the nobles, this was Nehemiah, and to the rulers of the rest of the people, be not afraid of them. Remember the Lord. Listen, folks. Don't be afraid of things to hurt, destroy you. Remember the Lord. Can I get a witness here now? Which is and terrible. That means awesome and mighty, what it means. And fight for your brethren, for your sons and your daughters and your wives and your houses. Listen. We don't have to be afraid tonight if we'll remember the Lord. If we'll remember the Lord. When you feel like this, you just got to throw in the towel. Just say, God, I'm just going to stay 5 more minutes. I'm just going to praise you for another minute or two before I quit. You start praising him. 5 minutes will go by and you will won't quit. 50 minutes will go by and you won't quit. 5 days will go by and you won't quit. 50 years will go by and you still won't quit. Because you've remembered the Lord. And when you remember the Lord, things change in your circumstances and your situations. There's somebody here tonight that you've really, it's just in your nervous system, has really been giving you a hard way to go. It just, amen, it seems like it wants to drive you, but it's not going to be able to do that in the name of Jesus. Oh, somebody just raise your hands right now and praise him right now by the power of God. Amen. Somebody's here really, but God's getting ready to fight for you. God's already fighting for you. Amen. But he's going to show himself strong in the name of the Lord. Come on, just raise your hands and love him for just a moment tonight. Hallelujah. There's a time, folks, when nothing else matters. Hallelujah. By the power of the Holy Ghost. Come on, just love him tonight. Hallelujah. By the power of God. I feel the anointing of the Holy Ghost right now. Telling somebody God's remembering you right now. Don't hang your harp on a willow tree. Remember that God is with you. Amen. I want to give you this definition one more time. Amen. The word remember means, amen, a deeper meaning than just to bring to one's mind. but it's also to act on that person's behalf. To have awareness and a realization, not just of the past of what God has done, but what God's going to do for you for the future. Can I get a witness in this house? Amen. Daniel, I think I've got one more place. I didn't write it down. Amen. But I want you to go there if you would with me. I believe it's Matthew chapter 6 tonight. Matthew chapter 6. Amen. About verse 25, if I'm correct. I could be wrong there. Amen. Hallelujah. How many knows that God's a mighty good God tonight? Amen. As they get prepared to come to the music, amen, I want you to remember one thing. God's fighting your battle tonight. Raise your hands. I feel the Holy Ghost on this tonight, that God's fighting your battle tonight. Hallelujah. Come on. Hallelujah. Come on, raise your hands and love him tonight, would you? Hallelujah. Amen. Come on, you give him just a praise right now in the name of the Lord. In the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. He's a mighty good God tonight. Hallelujah. I know one thing. God's answering somebody's prayer in this building tonight. Hallelujah. In the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. In the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. Amen. Hallelujah. I can't find it right there, but I'll tell you what it is. Tell you what it says. Amen. If God has his eye on the sparrow and he remembers the sparrow that falls to the ground. He knew where it fell. And to a point, he knew the name. Amen. He gave the stars a name. I don't know if he didn't give all the little birds a name. And he knows where that little sparrow fell. And if God knows where that little sparrow fell, how much greater are we tonight? God sees you tonight. God knows the times that you've had some hardships. But God's remembered you tonight. And I believe in the midst of a famine, God's going to work it for you. When God told me to build this church, it's time for us to move, for us to build another church and to move. We was in a recession, you know that? It was hard times. People said that's the wrong time to build a church. But God said to build. When God says to build, there ain't no recession in God's kingdom. Ain't no recession. And you know what? We went ahead and built just like that. Hey, man, that if the money was flowing like a river. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. At times it was flowing like a river out. Somebody shout hallelujah. Hallelujah. Amen. But I want you to know one thing. The meal barrel never run dry. And the cruise of oil, it never failed. Sometimes he got down that we got a handful and said, wow. But I went back the next day, and that was enough for the next day. And 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 we paid everything, amen. And when the payments came due every month, the payments was boom, boom, paid. Hallelujah. You know how come? Because God is faithful to remember you. Amen. Stand to your feet all over this building tonight. Amen. Hallelujah. There it is. Thank you, Daniel. Amen. Wherefore I say to you, take no thought for your life or what you shall eat or what you shall drink, nor yet for your body what you shall put on. Is not life more than meat and the body more than raiment? Behold, the fowls of the air, for they sow not. You don't see no little bird out here breaking up ground, sowing corn and beans and taters and no. But I've never seen a skinny bird. Somebody shout hallelujah. Woo! Amen. Tell your neighbors, I ain't never seen no skinny bird yet. I seen a bluebird one time called Flappy, and he wasn't no count. But anyhow, the rest of them's all right. They neither sow, no, they don't reap. Neither do they gather. Now, God's not telling us to be lazy. God just saying, hey, I know how to provide for you. I'll give you seed. I'll bless you. And I'll bless your crops. I'll bless everything you do. How many believe that tonight? Amen. And neither gather the barn. Yet your heavenly Father feedeth them. Are ye not much better than they? More valuable, what that means. Amen. Tonight, I want you to raise your hand and say, God, I thank you that you remembered me tonight. God, you remember me in my need, in my situation. And God, you have not forgot all those times of sacrifices. You have not forgot all those times, God, that I was obedient. God, when it looked like that I was wrong as far as the natural. But God, I obeyed you. Come on, talk to him right now. Just say, thank you, Lord, for remembering me. Thank you for remembering. If you just got saved, thank God, God remembered you to save you. He did, sis. If you ain't been saved very long, thank God. God's remembered you. You're still saved tonight by the grace of God. Just raise your hands and love him tonight. That God's not forgot you. Haman meant it to kill Mordecai. He hated him with a passion. But Haman wound up hung on his own gallows and his sons because he touched the power and the anointing of God. Folks, I'm going to tell you something. You're precious in the eyes of God tonight. I wish somebody could really get a hold of what I'm preaching to you. I feel that's so serious tonight. It'd been easy to cancel service tonight, but I had a burden in my spirit. Had a burden in my spirit. God gave me this. Somebody.